Here's the song, Tony. It's track 29. Call me boy once more, and you'll get to shine. Here we go.
The Red Rooster, not to be outdone, Bad News Brown, and then we go to the Bushwhackers. But right now, we go to ringside.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall.
Who's on his way to the ring to begin wrestling challenge?
Hailing from Glens Falls,
New York. Jim Duggan and the 2x4 are supposed to be reckoned with here in the World Wrestling Federation in the decade of the 90s, Tony Schiavone.
Jim Duggan.
Absolutely not. He doesn't need any introduction. He's happy all the time. Just happy to be alive.
Aimed and ready to go. His opponent is Pez Watley.
Pez Watley, no stranger to the squared circle. Been around for quite some time. Got some good victories over some very strong opponents. However, I don't like his chances in this one.
Momentum, Exxon Jim Duggan. And he sends Pez Watley back to the corner. You got to realize when you go up against Exxon, he's going to try to mow you down with those big clotheslines and turn his attention away. Gets the fans right behind him.
Well, you can do that when you have confidence. You can do that when you have ability. And when you're having fun. Look out.
Great atomic drop. Down goes Watley.
Hacksaw told me he was thinking about getting a haircut for 1990, Tony.
Yes.
I told the check for Brunei.
I guess he would do it quickly for us.
No charge.
No charge at all. I don't know how he would look with a haircut, but
might be a different individual altogether.
I'm sure those elbows.
Whoa! Right into the steel post.
Those elbows and those clotheslines would not change at all. The same Hacksaw in the ring. All business.
Throws his opponent out, brings him back in, helps him back in. Nice front face lock.
He has been all over Pez Watley. No question about that. Watley has not mounted an offensive move at all.
Not because he hasn't tried. He hasn't been given the opportunity, and that's what it's all about. Don't let the other guy get untrapped.
You're right. Even though Hacksaw turns, looks to the fans, throws the thumbs up many times. When the time is right, he moves right in for the move.
Uh-oh, there's the sign. Fingers up in the air.
Hacksaw, here we go. Right out with a giant clothesline and a cover.
Lights out. Display here, planted him right where he wants him, now waits for him, and levels him with that clothesline, the beginning to the end.
Catching the 2x4, we take you to the special report.
From the World Wrestling Federation magazine, this is Special Report.
Hello, everyone. This week's special report brings news we have all been waiting for. The official word on WrestleMania 6. The place, Sky Dome in Toronto, Canada. And the date, Sunday, April the 1st. In the coming weeks, this program will keep you fully informed on the news of events scheduled for WrestleMania 6. Now, Last week on Wrestling Challenge, the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, Andre the Giant and Haku, the Colossal Connection, were savoring yet another brutal victory when suddenly their celebrations were rudely interrupted. Let us look at what happened.
Once Andre is in, you can seal that victory.
Obviously, hatred runs very deep between these four men, and both teams appear to be on a collision course that is bound to be extremely destructive. For the World Wrestling Federation, this has been Special Report.
Gorilla Monsoon,
for one fall.
Sky Dome in Toronto, the site of WrestleMania 6.
Surprise, surprise, Dallas, April 1st, the first, Alan indeed, Hartman. WrestleMania going to Toronto, Canada. I love it. That's where I started my career, Tony. Toronto, one of my favorite places.
Tremendous city. Another tremendous city, Vero Beach, Florida, the home of the Red Rooster. Listen to the response and look at the crowd on hand for the WWF.
Federation action and wrestling challenge.
And a hot athlete, the Red Rooster. A variety of moves.
I like this youngster. Nice personality, too.
And that's right. And the fans really respond to that.
Not too crazy about his hairdo, but...
Well, it's unique. You can look at that hairdo and say, we know who that is.
It certainly is unique, unless you're at Venice Beach in California, I guess, and then you're just another one of the troops.
Alan Martin missed that one, but the Red Rooster did not. And now over the ropes to the right side, getting the momentum going. He's got Martin. Watch out here. Great move.
Beautiful hip lock, high elevation. Catches him with a nice arm drag. He's in control of this one.
Sign of a great athlete is the fact that he can have those moves work even when he's not ready to execute some offense. He can do a couple of leaps until he gets ready.
Oh, nice kick out. A little bit slow on the elbow drop.
Wow, he's on top of
maybe the rooster was too fast.
One or the other. Alan Martin is no slow man at all, but the Red Rooster is just a little bit too quick here. Staying right on him. Oh, he caught an elbow that time. Now Martin tried to put something together. That's a second great move. Let's see what Martin can do here as the Red Rooster drops down. Once again, the quickness gorilla picks him up. Nicely done up against the top rope.
Well, Martin wasn't exactly sure what he wanted to do when he came off that rope. Little indecision on his part cost him.
Yeah, that's a key point. It's always been a key point for the Rooster. Always knowing what he wants to do. Right now, though, Martin, great move. Sending the Rooster down that time as the Rooster put the head down and really telegraphed out.
Made a mistake. Called a mistake. Can't take your eyes off your opponent regardless of the move.
The Rooster gets one right up against the jaw and sends him back to a corner.
He'll be checking that one out.
He's right on target. And now the Rooster is in real big trouble here.
That's where you got to catch a guy if you're going to use an uppercut. Catch him right where the ramus of the mandible articulates with the mandibular fossa of the temporal bone. And that'll do it.
I imagine it would. The Rooster struts around the ring after the great neck breaker on Martin. He's going right after Martin once again.
I think this is the beginning of the end.
Vertical suplex. Man, the Rooster ready to wind it up, which could mean a chicken wing. Let's see.
Softening up that left arm and shoulder.
Here he goes, Gorilla.
There it is.
Camelot kind of reversed it, pulls him up, and there's your chicken wing. Didn't take long. The chicken wing was stuck on Alan Martin. Let's get the official word.
Here is your winner, the Red Rooster.
A lot of fans here, the Red Rooster. Not hard to understand why we got talent like this guy has. Let's go back and take a look at some of the exciting moves during the this match. Nice leapfrog there, but then look, put his head down, pull him back, that backdrop. And then the jawbreaker. Wow, that'll give you Excedrin headache number 35. And there it is.
Once again with a chicken wing, the Red Rooster makes it look easy.
Yes,
the feathers were really flying.
Giving away 300 at least.
Wow. Peak looks to
like a handicap match.
I was going to say Peak needs to maybe hit and run, but there's a lot of hitting and no running going on right now.
Well, he's getting hit.
And the earthquake right at him, right to the midsection. You have to realize from what we have seen, missed the clothesline. Watch out. Peak catches it. From what we've seen before, the Canadian earthquake has to be a big force in the WWF. Just ask Jimmy Hart.
Calm down, Earthquake! You're breaking too many reference nails! Tell them what you're gonna do!
Nobody in the WWF is gonna escape me! I'm gonna give everyone the Earthquake, and everyone's gonna feel it!
Had a big tattoo there on his left arm, Tony Giovanni. Couldn't quite make out what it was, though.
Well, he says he's going to give everyone the Earthquake. Oh, my goodness. Once he puts it on, I don't think there's any question he can't get up. The question is to try to be able to stay away from the Earthquake.
Don't be on the receiving end of it. That's the key. That's the counter for it.
I'll be very interested to see how someone like the Earthquake would fare against the Ultimate Warrior. I know there's certainly a big issue between the Warrior and Dino Bravo right now, and you know the Warrior has to look at the Canadian Earthquake and realize it.
Oh, there it is. Started his own Earthquake.
Over the ropes, here he comes. The tremor before the Earthquake.
Squashed him like a grape.
It was all Canadian Earthquake, and you can see the mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart, in with a flag, waving the flag around. It was a tremendous win, and the mouth of the South has to be happy. We have another tremor going on, Gorilla Monsoon.
This is the aftershock, I guess, from the Earthquake. He's going to level him again.
Oh, no.
Give me a break, Warrior, Rip.
Oh, we had a tremor, an Earthquake, an aftershock, and then another one.
He could have a crank start up here. Let's go back and take a look at some of the moves of the Earthquake. Watch this. Look at that. Brute strength just elevated him some 8 or 10 feet high by yesterday's garbage. And then a choke slam, we call that, Tony Giovanni. That's an illegal move, I might add. And then that. Wow.
Well, Lee Peak will never feel the same. An unfortunate result of a Canadian Earthquake, along with the mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart. Another tremendous win, and we take you now to Sean Mooney in the Event Center.
I'm Sean Mooney, and you folks here in Nashville have the perfect opportunity to see World Wrestling Federation action live and in person Thursday night, February 15th at the Nashville Auditorium. In fact, Mr. Perfect will be here to defend his perfect record along with his advisor, the genius, Mr. Perfect, taking on Hacksaw Jim Duggan. In other action, the mighty Hercules, he faces the genius, but the genius will be on his own in that matchup. The Bushwhackers in tag team competition, they will battle the Russian Bolsheviks, Nikolai Volkov and Boris Zhukov in a return bout. Brutus the Barber Beefcake, he faces the model Rick Martel. And in the main event, the Macho King Randy Savage to tangle with Dusty Rhodes. Now, both superstars will bring along their managers. For Dusty Rhodes, it's Sapphire. For the Macho King, it's the sensational Queen Sherry. And standing by right now with more on this great tag team matchup are the Russian Bolsheviks. They're talking about the Bushwhackers.
Bushwhackers, we've waited a long time to get you into the ring. You see, the Bolsheviks are back, and we are better than ever. Butch and Luke, you're crazy in the head. I don't see how you get away with what you do in the ring. You have no respect for the rules, no respect for the referee. You see, Bushwhackers, it takes a lot more to win than just size and strength. Because we have the size and strength, but we have the smarts here. Something you don't have, Bushwhackers. Our comrade.
No problem to us, Bushwhackers. You have a time to be at the time, though, the time will be the Северинську стражницю. Зато ви будуєте, що там направите все це. Мавіка там заб'ємо, як не заб'ємо чорну землю. Моя комарати заб'ємо чорну землю. Як ти заготов? Єсі, ні!
Nikolai Volkoff and Boris Zhukov to face Luke and Butch in that tag team match. The genius, he takes on the mighty Hercules.
You know, it doesn't take anybody with a real high IQ. It doesn't take a Rhodes Scholar, the President of the United States, or a butcher, a baker, or a candlestick maker to figure one thing out and one thing only. That maybe this time, Mr. Genius, maybe you can figure it out because you're the genius. That this time, bronze is gonna beat brain. All you gotta do is take one good look at me, Mr. Genius. Yeah!
Hercules faces the genius Thursday night, February 15th, here in Nashville at the Nashville Auditorium. Right now, feel the power of the WWF.
Nintendo Entertainment System presents Ravishing Rick Rude. Not known for his manners, but more for his brutal tactics, an encounter with a ravishing one most often turns out to be a rude awakening. Apparently, rude behavior leads to victory.
A few more bushwhackers right there.
The bushwhackers into the ring. Look at the hands. Yeah.
They have Mike McGurk got out of there in a hurry.
Well, they have Luke and Butch. And then again, there's Luke.
I think Mike got a whiff of the brawling. Which you called out.
Little scrub on top of the head for good luck that time. And Luke and Butch. Set to go on this tag team lift. There's another tag team looking on. Let's hear in from the Bolsheviks.
Bushwhacker, яка забіє американська своє, я вас забіє в чарну землю, як не смірдіш.
Подобали, Bushwhacker, the Bolsheviks, I took the team, the team to run Latin, Bushwhacker, we're going to get rid of you, I'm the World Wrestling Federation, for good.
Was that Boris translating for Nikolai, or?
Nikolai translating for Boris.
I don't know.
I think the message is loud and clear, though. They want to have nothing to do with the Bushwhackers, and they want to put them out, not just secure a win against them. And that's not an easy thing to do.
No, it isn't. They're so unorthodox, so unpredictable. Brooklyn Brawler in there right now, having a little bit of success.
And he's going right after the Bushwhackers, fighting fire with fire, a bite right to the head of Luke.
Well, at least he's got some teeth. Oh, look out. He can triple cross.
And now the tag is made. Watch out. Butch. All right. To the south end of a northbound brawler.
Well, Butch has got some teeth left in him, and he can do a little bit of that.
And again, high impact maneuvers. We see it so many times. I think it'll be a great matchup. The Bushwhackers, the Bolsheviks.
Oh, great one. No question about it. Hard to pick a winner in that one. Look at the brawler. He didn't waste any time getting out of there. He didn't want any more part of the Bushwhackers.
You know, it's apparent, Gorilla, they pull a lot of their energy from the fans, don't they? They really
certainly do.
Look out for the fans for response. They really appreciate all the fans. The mimics of the Bushwhack bounce when they come in. It really means a lot to the Bushwhackers. And in turn, they really give the fans 100%.
What a source to be able to tap at any given time. I mean, they don't need to tap it too much here against these two individuals, but against a team like the Bolsheviks, they might need a lot of help.
I would think so. And a tag, and here we go again. And wrapped in, I guess maybe underneath, all the bushwhacking, the licking, the scratching, and all the crazy antics they do is a great precision tag team in many ways.
Absolutely.
Two great athletes.
They give you a sense of false security.
That's right.
And then they go to boom on you.
The brawler back in now. He wants to do some high impact maneuvers. Oh, Butch caught him. Great timing that time from Butch with the Butchmaker. Right to the eyes. Watch out, the brawler. He went out again quickly, didn't he?
He certainly did. Made a hasty retreat there.
Mike Justin not faring much better at all. Here we go.
Double team slingshot. Uh oh.
There's your great double team move. The great tag teams of the WWF all have a great double team maneuver. And you're going to see it here with the Bunchbackers. First the battering ram. And then the double knee drop.
And then go to the shots.
Rivalries continue to heat up here in the World Wrestling Federation. It will be no exception here in Nashville Thursday night, February 15th at the Nashville Auditorium in that return encounter. Brutus the Barber Beefcake to face the model Rick Martel. And at the present moment, the model not real pleased with the barber's attempt to become a designer. In other action, Mr. Perfect will be here. He takes on Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
Mr. Perfect, I'm not going to take nothing away from you. You can do an awful lot of things very, very well. And wrestling is one of them. And now you got the genius running around outside the ring trying to tell you what to do. Well, that's fine and dandy. You tore up the world's heavyweight belt. Well, that's fine and dandy. But now you got something to say about Hacksaw Jim Duggan? Well, let me tell you something. Tough guy, you're not down at the convenience store pushing around some young punk kid. You got Hacksaw Jim Duggan, 6'3", 295 pounds, and I'm coming after you. And if that low-down genius gets in my way, you better believe I'll take you down too, pretty boy. Ho!
Hacksaw Jim Duggan, well aware of Mr. Perfect's reputation. Nonetheless, he believes he is just the superstar to end the Perfect streak. Brutus the Barber Beefcake, in a return encounter, he faces the model Rick Martel.
Beefcake, I was only trying to help you. I wanted to show you, to educate you on how a man with class should dress up like. And what do you do to thank me? You cut out my clothes, my beautiful clothes. You don't realize how much I value these clothes. And now you're laughing. You're having a good time. Yes, it's a big joke to you. Well, you don't see me laughing. And you're going to realize how much I value those clothes. You're talking about how you're going to shave my head now. Well, I'd be worried about how you're going to save your own skin. That's right, because now I'm upset. The model's about to lose his cool, and I don't know what's going to happen. Yes, because now, look at my eyes, Beefcake. Take a good look.
The model's focus remains clear on Brutus the Barber Beefcake, and the barber certainly knew how to upset a model, do something to his clothes. Thursday night, February 15th, the two collide at the Nashville Auditorium.
To the Nashville Auditorium, Thursday, February 15th at 7:30 p.m. Among the matches on the card, a return bout will find the model, Rick Martel, meeting Brutus the Barber Beefcake. Mr. Perfect faces Hacksaw Jim Duggan, and the Macho King, Randy Savage, will battle the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. Tickets available at the box office at all Centratech locations. The WWF, February 15th at the Nashville Auditorium.
The booms ring out here at the UTC Arena, and there is a loner.
Boy, he certainly is a loner. Always wants to be alone. Oh, doesn't he? Why does he do that, Tony?
I have no idea. Why would anyone turn his back on Bad News Brown? Bad News Brown is certainly a man unto himself. He is a solitary man.
Talk about solitary individuals. Did you the martial arts. Oh, look, no respect whatsoever for his opponent. Come on, referee, do something.
Right to the throat.
He'd be pounding the pavement looking for a job. Choke over the top rope. What's this youngster's name, Johnny? He's in trouble.
Bob Burrows.
He might want to burrow himself a hole somewhere and get in it because he's getting killed out there.
I would try maybe to roll out of the ring, but what do? If you go out of the ring,
go directly to the locker room. Change your stuff, pack your bag, and go home.
But you know, bad news, until the bell rings, going to follow you and maybe throw you into a ring post, hit you over the head with a chair.
Well, that's true.
So you just don't, there's no escape from bad news.
Yeah, but at least you could go home with a winner's share of the purse that way if you got himself disqualified. He's small consolation for the physical pounding that he's taking right now. But let's face it. Bad news could have put this youngster away 2 or 3 minutes ago, Tony. Chose not to. Chose to inflict some more punishment.
So, Gorilla, if you have a match with Bad News Brown, if you've signed the contract, what's the flaw in his armor? What do you look for? How do you defend yourself against this man?
You let him go in the ring first to begin with.
There you go.
That's number one. And number two, before he climbs in, you attack him.
Well, that certainly is not the strategy for Bob Burrows. And Bad News is just, taking a measure of him. He really shot him in, and now to the other side. Burrows is no match at all for the awesome power and ability of Bad News Brown.
He's on a rampage here.
Yeah, I like beating up the stack. I like it.
He's talking to his opponent as well.
Right to the throat. High impact mover, and down on the throat again. And now he's driving the knuckles right to the throat, for goodness sakes.
Talking about talking to your opponent. You bet there was some talking going on in the Royal Rumble when the Hulkster looked the Warrior right in the eye, Tony. I couldn't make it out from my vantage point what they were saying, but I know there was some words exchanged. And look at this. Here it comes.
Again. The Ghetto Blaster.
Right on the external occipital protuberance and lights out. Here's Mike.
Right on the what?
The external occipital protuberance.
Bad news, Brown.
Okay. He is bad news.
Oh, and again, he doesn't need to do this, for goodness sakes. Bob Burrows is out. He's out cold.
Here's some action that went down earlier on in the match. It was all, well, not much action. That's the end right there. Put the foot on his chest.
To the superstars of wrestling, the million-dollar man, Ted DiBiase, told Jake the Snake, you want it, you come and get the belt, and here's what happens.
Jake the Snake coming in the ring!
Virgil attacking him, actually it's Jake attacking Virgil.
DiBiase and Jake the Snake going at it.
Now what right does Roberts have to come down and interfere in DiBiase's match?
He was invited, you heard what he said, you want it, come and get it.
You see what happened? It's common knowledge to anybody that wind will fan a fire and make it spread, you know. Well, DiBiase, brother, you've been blowing so hard for so long, I had enough of it. And there was only one way to get to you. I couldn't get to you by doing something to Virgil. I couldn't get to you by inflicting a small injury. I couldn't get to you by taking your health. The only way you get to Ted DiBiase is hit him where it hurts.
Right enough.
No, no, no. Oh. That's not how you hurt Ted DiBiase. For all the pain that you've given me, for all the misery, for all the time on the sidelines just having to sit and wait, this was for you, my man. That's why I thought of this. That's why I did it. Nobody dares me to do anything.
Individuals over the years, and it always was a pleasure to be involved
and
in tag team
opponent.
Wrestling.
Boy, that would be something. Jim Powers over the top now. Jim Powers earned the legs of the hammer, and now, well, the hammer just caught him.
Didn't it? Certainly did. That's where experience is so important. Jimmy Powers on the short end of the stick in the experience category. When you compare him with a hammer.
You hear the mouth of the South in the background, and now pushing the hammer to the ropes once again. Experience comes out. Notice how quickly the hammer popped up when he missed the elbow.
Certainly did. Not the place to be on your back.
Watch out. Reynolds up top. Great maneuver. So he and Powers right after Valentine.
Well, at least this team is showing me some offense here.
Too close to the corner, Gorilla. It only took one Irish whip right in the corner as the double team's coming.
Kind of a mistake. And shout indeed, he can do that, and he can put you away in a hurry if he so desires. Claiming to have been the greatest Intercontinental Champion of all time, I don't know, I may have a problem with that.
Well, he certainly was one of the best.
He certainly was, no denying that.
And he still is, and now making a definite threat to the tag team scene in the WWF.
You know, let's not forget that the Macho King was at one time the Intercontinental Champion.
Tito Santana.
Pat Patterson, a name out of the past. Pedro Morales. The Hammer himself.
And a tag again.
How do you think the Hammer feels when Hawkey says I was the greatest Intercontinental Champion of all time?
Apparently he's putting all that behind him right now.
I doubt it.
They, right now, these two, the Honky Tonk Man and Greg the Hammer Valentine, the team called Rhythm and Blues, seem to be making a threat to move up in the rankings of the WWF Tag Team Wars, and certainly some great teams. We know the issue still burns between Demolition and the Colossal Connection. We've seen it.
They're already in the top five.
There you go.
It didn't take long.
Absolutely not.
And let's, you know, we've talked so much about their individual ability. They are looking great as a tag team here. They are keeping Reynolds in there half of the ring.
Well, if you can pick it up, I don't know whether you can or not, Tony, but you can hear the Colonel telling these guys when to get in and when to get out.
Well, he's always saying something. You just have to listen closely, I guess, to find out exactly what word is what. Uh-oh. Valentine.
The party's over.
There you go.
Little smart enough to call it in a hurry.
Little rhythm from the gorilla right there. And let's get the official word.
Here are your winners, the Rhythm and Blues.
Rhythm and Blues, indeed, looking good here this week on Wrestling Challenge. Kind of a mongrel team that's blended together very well.
A mongrel team. Hoggy Talk didn't miss up his hair much at all either, did he?
I couldn't even break a sweat. Shows me a lot more things than he would normally show me on any given time with an opponent, you know, like the one he's in there with right now.
Head like first, using some big guys. Yeah, some high impact maneuvers. Wow, he is taking the measure of Tony Burton in a hurry. Fans here in Chattanooga, Kenny, right along with him.
No, there's no music playing now, Coco. It's match time now.
Oh, there's music playing. He's the only one that can hear it.
I guess so. Another suplex. He can do it all if he wants to when he puts it all together. He didn't want the cover there, Tony. It was obvious to me. He didn't want to beat him there. He wants to show you some more of Coco's stuff.
A man of many moves. And Tony Burton out of that chicken wing trying to get to the ropes and succeeds. Coco getting the fans behind him. That's not too difficult to do. They are right behind this youngster out of Tennessee.
On a day that he's not wrestling, Tony, does he still have that same painting on his sideburns there like he does right now? I don't know. I've never seen it.
No, I don't know.
Probably.
Certainly would stick out walking down the street, though, wouldn't it?
Yeah, waiting for the bus or the subway or something, or hailing a cab somewhere. He caught a thumb right in the eye there. That'll slow anybody down.
Watch out. Wrong thing to do, Gorilla. He went right to the head to Tony Burton, tried to use a turnbuckle, and that time Coco fired back on him, and there's the reason. A solid headbutt right to Tony Burton.
Well, see, that's what happens. All these youngsters don't do their homework on their opponents. Consequently, they end up paying the price. Here he goes now, all the way up, perhaps. Yes. High risk area.
That's right. Got to take flights. Just a matter of time now, Gorilla.
Could be the beginning of the end here right now.
That could be it. No! Burton got out of it. Burton has absorbed a lot of punishment from Coco Beware.
I don't know whether that was a smart move on Tony's part or not.
No!
Sometimes it's wiser when you get your clock clean to just lay there, take the three count. Believe me.
Go back to the drawing board, right?
Absolutely. You know, tomorrow's another day. You're risking a chance of incurring some permanent type injury that, you know, Coco can lay that kind of injury on you in a hurry. Flying again.
Right on target again also. All those high-risk maneuvers have been on target to perfection. Frankie wants some popcorn. He's looking out to his left there.
Uh-oh. All those moves are going to lead up to this. Ghostbuster.
And you hear the oohs and ahs in the crowd. That was executed perfectly from Coco Beware.
Federation action to arrive at the Nashville Auditorium Thursday night, February 15th, and things will definitely get rowdy that evening when Hacksaw Jim Duggan faces Mr. Perfect. He's standing by with his advisor with more on this encounter.
I really thought I'd seen it all here in the World Wrestling Federation. Nobody's been able to match up to Mr. Perfect, and now they throw Hacksaw Jim Duggan in front of me. And Hacksaw Jim Duggan, see, my destiny is already out there. Everybody knows that I'm going to be the World Wrestling Federation champion, and sooner or later, I was going to have to wrestle you anyways. But Hacksaw Jim Duggan, what you don't know is why I'm Mr. Perfect, and until you felt me in that ring, you won't know. So I'm just going to tell you one little thing, Hacksaw Jim. You bring all them screaming fans, and you bring your 2x4 into the ring. Only don't be swinging it my way, because if you do, I'm going to embarrass you like I have everybody else, the perfect way.
According to Mr. Perfect, the year of perfection will continue after Thursday night, February 15th. The Macho King, Randy Savage, he tangles with Dusty Rhodes.
Oh, yes! Public embarrassment was what it was called. Millions of people around the world heard Sherry run down my supper. Heard her ridicule in public, if you will. The American dream to common people. And talk about what kind of people and clothes we wear. Woo, that made me mad. Because what happened, baby? The queen got slapped. And the king got rode, but not lied. You gon' be Rhodes, baby. You wanted the American dream, Dusty Rhodes. You gon' get him, brother. And Sapphire is gon' be watching out for one share. Come here, baby.
Woo! Sherry, I'm gonna slap you again if I get the chance.
Woo! And you know it, Savage.
It appears that Sapphire has already taught Dusty Rhodes a few new moves. He's ready to meet the Macho King February 15th. Also that same Thursday evening at the Nashville Auditorium, the mighty Hercules, he takes on the genius, the Russian Bolsheviks, to collide with the Bushwhackers. In a return encounter, it's Brutus the Barber Beefcake facing the model Rick Martel. Mr. Perfect accompanied by the genius when he takes on Hacksaw Jim Duggan, and both managers at ringside in the main event when Dusty Rhodes meets the Macho King Randy Savage. Thursday night, February 15th at the Nashville Auditorium.
Get ready for our feature matchup next week right here on the Wrestling Challenge. It is Tito Santana against Dino Bravo, and now let's hear comments from both.
Tito Santana, the match has been signed right here next week.
This is your chance to get rid of one more Dino. Arriba, kid, you and I, you're going to find out what it's like to get crushed by the world's strongest man. Dino Bravo, you and I are going to meet here next week. If you think I'm going to stand there and let you use your strength, no, it doesn't work that way. What you're going to see is this Mexican coming at you from every angle. Your strength will not catch up to my speed. Arriba!
Awesome. also, fans, don't forget this weekend, a gigantic tag team matchup. Hulk Hogan, the Ultimate Warrior, against Mr. Perfect and the Genius. Let's hear comments from both teams.
This weekend will be a perfect opportunity to prove intellectual superiority.
For this is the weekend that history will be made here in the World Wrestling Federation. For Hulkamania and the Ultimate Warrior will both go down in defeat to the Genius and yours truly, Mr. Perfect.
This weekend, the Ultimate Warrior and Hulkamania, the two strongest forces in the WWF, are going to prove that the Genius isn't so darn smart and that Mr. Perfect is not perfect.
They should be talking with the Hulkamaniacs in the way, and the others are hanging to the outside covering. Let's stop them in the seats and then go to Parsada!
And don't forget, that feature tag team matchup will happen this weekend. For Gorilla Monsoon, I'm Tony Schiavone. We'll see you next week right here on WWF Wrestling Challenge.